Sudoku is a brain game that can keep you entertained for hours, at least during times when there was no phone and only 100 Sudoku grid book available. The goal of the game is to fill the grid in a way that there are no duplicates on the same row, column, or square. And in this video, we want to check if a given Sudoku grid is valid. In other words, we want to check if the rule of no duplicates is respected. Know that we'll just check if it's valid, we won't solve it. Solving it is another story. And the fact that a grid is valid doesn't even mean that it's solvable. The brute force solution is that for each cell that contains a number, for example the one in blue-green, we traverse its row, column, and square to check that there is no cell that contains the same value. But this solution has an O of n cubed time complexity, where n is the size of the grid, because we have n rows times n columns times 3n to check a cell's unicity, n for the row, n for the column, and n for the square. The optimized solution that we're gonna use works by using sets. We will use a set for each row, a set for each column, and a set for each square. Then for each cell, we just have to check if it's already existent in the set of its row, column, or square. And if it does, then it's a duplicate, we return false, else we just add it and we continue. And the cool thing with this solution is that we need to traverse each cell only once. Okay, let's see an example. We want to check if this grid is valid. Its size is 9, the regular Sudoku grid size. We need 9 sets for rows, 9 sets for columns, and 9 sets for squares. Let's start. We have 8. We can't find it in set of row 0, column 0, and square 0, so we just add it to them and we continue. Next cell, 3. We can't find it in set of row 0, column 1, and square 0, so we just add it to them and we continue. Next cell, it's an empty cell, so we do nothing. Next cell, same thing. Next cell, 7, row 0, column 4, square 1, we just add. Then empty, 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 and empty. Then 6, row 1, column 0, square 0, we add. Then empty, empty, then 1, we add. Then 9, we add. Then 5, we add. Then empty, 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 and empty. Then 9, even if we've seen a 9 before, but it was neither on the same row, nor on the same column, nor on the same square, so we just add. Next cell, 8, we cannot find it on row 2, on column 2, but we can find it in square 0. It's in the set of square 0, so we return false because this grid is not valid. In this particular LeetCode problem, we're dealing with grids of size 9 only, so we need 9 sets for rows, 9 sets for columns, and 9 sets for squares. And by the way, to identify which square cell belongs to starting from its position in the grid, we can calculate the Euclidean division of the row by 3, multiply it by 3, and add to it the Euclidean division of the column by 3. For example, if a cell is at row 3, column 8, then it belongs to the square 5, because 3 divided by 3 is 1, multiplied by 3 is 3, plus 8 divided by 3, which is 2, we get 5. Okay, let's continue. Now we traverse cells of the grid by using nested for loops, I is for the rows and G for the columns. And at each iteration, if the cell is empty, we do nothing. Else if we can find it in rows of I or columns of G or squares of I divided by 3 multiplied by 3 plus G divided by 3, we return false. Rows of I represents the set that contains values of the row I, columns of G represents the set that contains values of the column G, and same logic for the square. Else, we just add grid of IG to each one of them and we continue. If we do all the iterations without the function returning false, then the grid is valid, we can return true. And this solution has an O of n squared time complexity because traversing the grid requires n squared iterations and searching in a set has an O of 1 time complexity on average. And for the space complexity, we're using 3n sets that can contain up to n elements, so it's also n squared. We reach the end of this video, like and subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next one.